As it was said, once more into the breach. I had a really fun game recently as Elder Titan, and I feel like I should share it. The game turned out fairly well. I mean, I didn't do too particularly well, but Gyrocopter carried us like crazy, so it didn't matter. Yeah, let's go ahead and get right into this. Ooh, that's a lovely Abaddon. Abaddon! Ignore the voice cracks. Let's fast forward through the picking stage. Someone random's Tiny, they decide not to keep it. Someone random's Slark, they decide to keep it. And seeing as someone has random Slark, of course I would pick Elder Titan. It's a great counter to Slark. I don't think their Crystal Maiden did too particularly well either. And like I said, this Gyrocopter just went mad. Went ham. One of these for when I get interrupted by sassy remarks. I'm still going to keep this on player perspective. I'm going to talk a bit less. Last time I feel like I talked too much. Tried to fill the silence when it wasn't really necessary to do so. Alright, here we are. Elder Titan, silencer. Oop, let's stop fast forwarding. It's in the bag. People are claiming that it's in the bag on their team. They don't even know about this Gyrocopter and his abilities. Getting starting items, the standard process. I decided to get some wards this time around. I don't usually do that on Elder Titan, but seeing as we didn't have anyone else who wanted to pick up wards, I just did it. Screw going for third position. That's current gold. I need to net worth. There we go. It already knows. It already knows. It put Gyro right at the top. Alright. Silencer's going to get this rune. I don't think they get the one bought. Yeah. Gyrocopter runs into... there was a little bit of lag there. Gyrocopter runs into several enemies. Yeah, he said hi to them. Now in this, I picked Elder Titan because it was a counter to Slark, and I thought everything was going to go well. What could possibly go wrong? Well, one thing that could possibly go wrong is I could wind up solo. What's worse, I wind up solo against, look at who that is. I wonder who that could be charging me right now. Who in this game has a charge ability that they could be running at me with right now? I don't know, maybe it's him. Maybe it's frickin' Spirit Breaker, and Bloodseeker is laning with him. Luckily, I managed to escape that little gank, but I am spooked. Gyrocopter's going ham, straight from the beginning. Pretty sure he just goes ham all frickin' game. So luckily, it's not going to matter whether I get a lot of farm top or not, because he's going to compensate for my inability to solo against a Bloodseeker and a Spirit Breaker. I get a few last hits anytime it gets pushed beneath the tower, but I still struggle. Bloodseeker goes into the jungle here. I think I call him missing, but he's actually just right over there. Using the Elder Spirit to try and harass a bit, spook them out. Some people don't know what that does. Some people think it does damage over time, so they run away from it if I chase them with it. It's kind of funny. Trying to use the Astral Spirit buff to get some more last hits as well. Not able to use that to full advantage, to its fullest advantage since it's only level 1. Yeah, there I go, calling Bloodseeker missing. He's just right over there in the jungle. I keep trying to harass this Bloodseeker, but like I said earlier, I cannot lane against a Bloodseeker. He just regenerates anything I hit him with. I don't have enough high damage nukes. I don't have enough damage to take him out quickly. And if you can't take him out quickly, he's just going to go regen health or run away at the speed of a freaking bullet train. I'm not sure how things went mid. It looks like there are three Shadow Fiends currently mid. Who is laning against him? Silencer mid? Oh, okay. I think he does okay. He winds up in second position. I get a ton of creeps in that Astral Spirit, so I get a bunch of damage. I try and walk up here and hit Bloodseeker with that Astral Spirit buff damage, but it's not really worth it, I don't think, so I just back away. I'm by no means an expert at Elder Titan, but I mean, I just started playing him a few days ago, but I think I'm doing at least comparably. Comparably? Is that?
Yes.
Decently. Bloodseeker charging at me, trying to get as much harassment in on me as he can, since I don't regenerate health like crazy. Low on mana for most of the early game, that's the way it's going to be until I get my Soul Ring. Saw Crystal Maiden over there. See, do I have Fog for both teams on? Yeah, I should switch that over to the Radiant. I don't think I actually saw Crystal Maiden over there when I was actually playing this game. It's just a part of the replay. Now this time, Bloodseeker tries to initiate on me while I'm under tower. He's still forced to back off. And I get a bunch of Astral Spirit buff damage from that, but as I've decided earlier, it's futile to try to use that to hit him because he's just going to regenerate anything that I hit him for. I can't nuke him. My Clarity gets taken down by a range creep there. I was a bit unfortunate. Still not much happening. Bottom has been won because of their pseudo tri lane. Top has been lost because I was soloing against a Bloodseeker. Well, I can't say I really lost yet. I haven't died, but I haven't been getting the XP that I or the gold that I need. I've been getting all the XP. Silencer seems to be doing okay mid. Let's see, has he? Silencer took a bounty rune. Silencer hasn't killed anyone, and neither has Shadow Fiend. So both of the mids seem to be doing, I wouldn't say poorly, they're just not ganking and they're not killing one another. It's just sort of a neutral lane. Right now I'm in fourth position. I was trying to go for third position, but Earthshaker is out farming me bot in a tri lane. I wonder how many last hits that Earthshaker has. It's hard to read because I have some recording UI over top of this. Now here, Bloodseeker goes on me with his Rupture. I try and stomp him, but he gets out of the way of that, and then I just accept my death. Because there's nothing I can do. I can't run away with a Rupture on me, because that'll kill me. I'm silenced. Doesn't matter, because I didn't have enough mana to cast anything anyway. So, he gets me. Earthshaker does not have more last hits than me, but yet he has more gold. He must have been in the area of effect gold thing for all the people that he's murdering. Good work, Gyro. Did I ever commend him? I could do that right now. Hey, Gyro. I cannot commend him. Darn. Now here I'm trying to go on the Bloodseeker, trying to just get him out from underneath my tower, but it did not work too well. I suppose I accomplished what I set out to do, but I didn't damage him much. Not that it would matter anyway, because he's just going to roar and then get a little bit of extra health back. Back to the net worth chart. Here I just roam to place another ward, doing the... I guess I'm in fourth position right now, so that's not really a bad thing for me to be doing. It puts me out of position here, though. I think I try to do something here to force him back out from underneath my tower. Try to stomp on him and miss, and then he ruptures me. Wander back under my tower. I'm going to get silenced, and then he kills me.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I think Spirit Breaker charged me at some point, but then canceled it. I guess he assumed that Bloodseeker was capable of killing me on his own. Radiant's top tower was crushed to smithereens. Luckily, Gyrocopter is still winning bot.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Wow, right now I'm in 5th position. Jeez. I guess it's a good thing I stay here and farm for a little while. I don't think anyone bothers me either. Meanwhile, they're fighting for their lives bot against 5. Bloodseeker's fairly well farmed as well because I've died to him a couple of times. Here I am, hovering over here trying to see what's going on and walking there in case they need me, but it doesn't look like they're going to need me. Gyrocopter is a boss. It's got a heat-seeking missile following Bloodseeker. Shadow Fiend isn't able to kill it. That might actually kill Bloodseeker. Yep, there it is. Dead. That's what you get for running. So now I've returned to lane. I'm just going to continue to farm since I'm way behind. Haven't even gotten my power treads yet. Still not the best at last hitting, but I seem to be competent. Finally get my power treads, but Lina's using the courier, so I wait for that. Slark finally gets his power treads. Apparently he's suffering similarly to me.
Unstoppably scary.
He's only in 4th position on his team, but that's not really where he belongs. He belongs in 2nd position on that team. Gyrocopter still being a boss, killing everything that comes his way without any help. He does not need a team, which is useful for me. Lina dies of the rupture. I think she was just hoping to get far enough away and then stop, not realizing that she was losing much more health than she thought she was. I rotate mid closer to my team since the majority of them are bot. That way, in case they need help, I can be there quicker. Not to mention I can help silence or push the mid tower if he so desires. I get 88 damage out of that one hero, Astral Spirit. That was really nice.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Now this is what everybody really plays Elder Titan for. Natural Order. Reduces all elements to their basic levels, removing base armor and magic damage resistance from nearby enemy units. Basically, once this hits level 4, Slark is worthless, Spirit Breaker is hurt quite a bit, Bloodseeker is hurt quite a bit. Anyone who has, excuse me. Anyone who has very high agility stats, people who rely on their armor to tank damage, they'll be getting a lot out of... they'll be being harmed by that quite a bit. Now that was quite a little team fight. Well, not necessarily a team fight. Not everyone's here. What is happening right now? With my throat. Ugh. I run in there and try to stomp on some people. Crystal Maiden, I think, gets away here, and then Shadow Fiend comes up behind me with a haste rune, so I can't get away from him. I think I die here. Yep, there it is. Dead. I guess I over-pursued on that Crystal Maiden, thinking I might be able to kill her with a stomp, and then once I got up to her with my Astral Spirit there, I didn't have enough mana to stomp. Like I said, I make a few mistakes in the early game. It costs me a few lives, but then I make a bit of a resurgence in the middle game, mid-game and late-game once I get some decent items, since Gyrocopter is able to compensate for my lack of items in the early game.
Dire's middle tower is under fire.
One seeker running down mid. Gyrocopter is being initiated on by... It looks like that's Spirit Breaker. And Spirit Breaker dies. Spirit Breaker, the master of initiation, dies while initiating. Nice work. Ooh! And he takes out Slark. He's gone beyond godlike in 13 minutes and 40 seconds. That is one good Gyrocopter. And thanks to him, I'm able to stay top here, continue farming a bit, catch up on some of the items that I've been missing, get 3 ranged creeps here off of the Astral Spirit buff. And a deny. Very important when no one's in your lane to deny all the creeps. Going for a Ring of Bacillus here. Get a little bit more mana regen, since mana has been a problem. I don't think I make the best use possible out of this Soul Ring. It's mostly just there for the... What is this component? The Sage's Mask, which helps me regenerate my mana more quickly. Now this Bloodseeker is kind of low, so I try to keep him that way. I know I can't kill him on my own, especially without my ulti, but I'm trying to keep him low so that if someone were to come mid, they might be able to help me kill him. Luckily, someone does just that, comes mid. Silencer, the guy who has quite a bit of nuking damage, comes up here and... What do you know? Nukes him. Dead. Nice work, Silencer. So now I'm back in fourth position, no longer in fifth position. Working my way back up to the third position that I was going for. My hope was to be above Lina and Earthshaker and below Silencer and Gyrocopter. Naturally, I'm trying not to steal any last hits from Gyrocopter. Not that he... It's not like he doesn't have a lot of money, but he can always use more. Got Shadow Fiend back there, trying to harass him with the Astral Spirits. Silencer gets him with a good curse. Now I'm trying to get as much buff out of this as I can. Gyrocopter mowing down creep waves. Gyro.
Dire's middle tower is in the wrong end of business. Radiant's bottom tower has uninvited.
We take the mid tower. Silencer gets the last hit. He gets more money. I get my Ring of Bacillus. Things are looking up from where they were looking earlier. If I recall correctly, a team fight breaks out near here. Yep, here he comes. Spirit Breaker's charging down in, initiating for everyone. Silencer pops his ulti. That gives me time to stomp. Those guys get crushed by Gyrocopter's cooldown. I drop my ulti. Shadow Fiend avoids it, but Crystal Maiden runs in there and ultis, but gets hit by it. And then I smack her for the last hit. Now I notice he's trying to get away here, so I drop my Astral Spirit on him. He doesn't get away. That's a team wipe in 16 minutes. Lovely. We leave here, we rotate to the bottom lane, and try to push that tower. But since it's only 16 minutes in, they all respawn rather quickly. Look, that Spirit Breaker's already back up. And so is Crystal Maiden. 12 seconds on the Slark, who has buyback, but why would you buyback to save a tier 2? Okay. Tier 1. Now I'm in a bit too far here, and I don't notice that my team is leaving, so I get initiated on and die. Another mistake. Luckily, I'm not gone for too long. I'm 3-4-3, that's... I'm almost neutral. May as well not be here.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Next item I go for, I think, is Drum. No, I go for Crimson Guard first. I need to tank up, because they have a lot of right-click. Between Bloodseeker and Slark, they could probably right-click me down rather quickly. Need to tank up a bit.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Here we are, all rotating top. Since the last team fight went so well, we're deciding to stick together and hopefully pull them into another team fight to save their towers. Or they can just lose their towers and we get money. That's fine.
Radiant's bottom tower has uninvited guests. Dire's top tower was.
We might be trading a tier 1 tower top for a tier 1 tower bot.
Radiant's bottom tower has an. Radiant's bottom tower.
Might push and take the tier 2 then. I think that's what we decide to do. I send the courier to the secret shop to pick up the vitality booster, fearing that a teamfight might break out soon and I die in it. I don't want to lose the money.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Here they come, TPing in. Spirit Breaker is charging gyrocopter. Bloodseeker's invisible there, but we don't know that. You can only see him there because it's a replay. And here's Spirit Breaker, jumping in. Silencer pops his ulti, and so does Gyrocopter. Spirit Breaker gets crushed. Shadow Fiend trying to get away, gets Yulzed. So is Crystal Maiden. Shadow Fiend gets nuked by Gyro. I kill the Crystal Maiden. Bloodseeker kills me, and Silencer is the only one left. Aside from Earthshaker, who was down there defending bot. I believe Silencer gets killed by the Bloodseeker here. You can't outrun a Bloodseeker. Yep, there you go. So that's 3-4. Not exactly the best trade we want to make, but... I suppose you could say we got a tier 1 tower out of it, but they took a tier 1 of ours as well. A double ulti out of Shadow Fiend really hurt Gyrocopter. Still in fourth position here. Trying to climb back up to third. Gyrocopter in first, following closely behind their first. I'm still working on my Crimson Guard. Don't quite have enough for the Ring of Health. I'm rather close, though, so I'm trying to avoid confrontation. Save up a bit of cash. Earthshaker picks up all kinds of wards. That'll assist in my rise back to third position. I got a Shadow Fiend mid here. I think I try to harass him with an Astral Spirit. He doesn't really care. I think he's learned what Astral Spirit does. Lina nukes the creep wave. I was going to take a few of those, but never mind. Really close to that Ring of Health. Gyro still taking last hits. He's catching up to Bloodseeker again. He dropped behind Bloodseeker when he died in that fight to the Shadow Fiend. 4-5-4, still close to neutral. Who is that? Slark TP's mid. We have Bloodseeker in our jungle. We're all gathered up mid. Looks like there might be a team fight mid soon, or perhaps in our jungle, if we notice the Bloodseeker. Yep, there's Shadow Fiend. Looks like Earthshaker's there. He's not going to initiate on a Shadow Fiend. Ooh, a smoke gank. Ah, that's right. Lena was rather fond of her smoke this game. Smoke of Deceit, we roam around through the river, and I think we take Roshan here. Yeah, smoke on Roshan. I stomp on Roshan, but I'm not sure. Does that actually affect him any? I throw down my astral spirit, and when I suck that back, I get a bit of a buff from him. Does he count as a neutral creep? I suppose. I stomp again. Not sure whether that actually does anything. Whether or not it actually does anything. Now they know we've taken Roshan. I saw... Who was that? It was Bloodseeker wandering his way down here. But I don't think he's going to catch us. Gyrocopter goes back to mid... No, he's going to the... He does not know what he wants to do. So I decide to go bot. With a group of others. We're going to push bot and try to take tier 1 tower there, since we've taken the tier 1 in all the other lanes. Why not try this?
Double damage.
This Shadow Fiend is mid, or presumably he's mid. Those might be illusions. No, that's not an illusion. That's the real him. This is Bloodseeker. This is a good time to push. They won't be able to get to us for some time. Take tier 1, and possibly take tier 2 if they decide not to rotate. They might just try to trade that other tier 2 for ours. Let's see how this goes. Someone is TPing to their tower. That was Crystal Maiden and Slark. Slark's coming in as well. Trying to save up for our Crimson Guard here. Earthshaker goes mid to try and stop them from taking that tier 2, but he does not succeed. He pushes them out after they take that tier 2 tower. Crystal Maiden runs up here, and I'm not quite sure what she had planned, but it did not work out the way she had it planned. I'm not sure if she knew all of us were here. Might have just thought it was Gyrocopter. Even still, that wasn't the greatest of ideas. I try and harass them with my astral spirit, see if I can get some sight beyond sight. I think I get quite the little buff from this as well. Once it gets back to me, it hits several ancient creeps. Yeah, look at that, 150 damage off of that astral spirit buff. Very nice. Now here, Bloodseeker initiates on Silencer, so does Spiritbreaker. I try to stomp the both of them, but I miss the Bloodseeker. Spiritbreaker gets crushed. And now I don't have ulti anymore. I probably should have saved that for this fight, but still we come out on top. Gyro's with me. We're taking down the Shadow Fiend. Gyro dies to the Shadow Fiend, but it doesn't matter. He has the thingamajigabobber. The Aegis. I die to... Who is that? Slark coming up behind me. Gyro nearly kills the Slark as he comes by, but a cheeky little invis gets him out of there. Very close to Crimson Guard now. I might be able to tank things when people come up from behind me after this. Gyro's pushing mid. Looks like he's getting back now that he realizes Spearbreaker is up.
Dire's middle tower is in the wrong end of business.
Lena buys a Yules. Our top lane is pushed, so presumably he'll go there.
Radiant's top tower needs bandages.
Lena just TP'd in. There might not be much left for him by the time he gets there. I finally gotten up into third position, which was where I wanted to be. Gyro is first, Silencer second, me third, Earthshaker fourth, Lena fifth. That's the way it should be. Their team seems to have straightened itself out a bit as well. Except, Spiritbreaker should not be below our fifth position. Illusion. Now I'm going for Drum, trying to get a bit of extra movement speed on the Astral Spirit. Use it to scout more, get more harassment in. Now here I wasn't thinking that one was real. Now realizing it's real, I try to go in there with the gyrocopter. I come back down the stairs, and I remember at this point in the game, I get hit by terrible lag. I can't even see what's happening right now, so I'm just standing there in the corner. Once the lag finally subsides, I pop my Crimson Guard. I notice Shadow Fiend there, stomp on him. Spirit Breaker initiates on me, thinking he might be able to get a kill on Gyrocopter. I think he succeeds, but then we kill him as well. A little bit of a kamikaze trade there. He gets quite a bit of money from that. So in the end, you might say it's worth it. I'm trying to get up there to help Silencer here, but I'm not sure where he's running to. So in the end, I just go back to mid and try to farm a bit more. Lina's going to prevent me from doing that, though.
Radiant's bottom tower has uninvited guests.
At this point, I'd say the game is going fairly well. We have 30 kills, they have 23. They have more towers down than we do, though, albeit by only one. I've finally gotten to the position I'm supposed to be in. Gyrocopter is way up there in terms of farm. He's doing very well. Try and get a few more last hits here. Oh, I notice Earthshaker's being initiated on in here, so I try to get up there and help him, but he has a blink dagger. He doesn't really need my help. Now here, we notice the Bloodseeker is sticking around, so we try to get up there and gank him. I think he gets away in this instance, though. Yeah, Shadowblade. We can't see where he is right now. He's being chased by the heat-seeking missile, so we could just follow the missile if we want. But I don't think we should dive that far. Everything's missing. We don't know where the enemy is. Things are quiet at the moment. Bloodseeker went mid after he got chased out of the jungle. Slark is TPing top. It looks like we're all going to rotate top and try to push there. Perhaps Gyrocopter and I will stay mid. Nope, we'd both go top. Okay. Here I am just looking at items, seeing what I should be getting next, and then I notice Bloodseeker initiating on Lina. So I try and go up there and help with that, but he's just too fast. He was invisible. I thought I might be able to get him with that stomp there, since he was recently stunned by Lina's stun. But, he's so freaking fast. Can't catch him. So in the end, we all decide to head mid. Looks like a fight's a-brewing, so I head up here. I saw a Crystal Maiden up there. Earthshaker blinks up there to scout. It doesn't see anything. With all of them missing, playing it a bit carefully. Finally, we catch sight of them. We all smoke. I'm not sure how effective smoke would be in this particular instance, but I doubt we're going to encounter very many wards. But in the end, we actually do encounter their team. Earthshaker blinks in there and misses an Echo Slam. I pop the Crimson Guard, and we get one of them. Smoke for one of them, and then Bloodseeker runs in here on the Earthshaker and manages to take him down. Shadow Fiend ulties, but for the most part misses it as well. We notice Slark up here, try and chase him, but he's faster than the heat-seeking missile. Can't really catch him. Spiritbreaker charges Silencer. Silencer is silenced. I try and go here on the Shadow Fiend, not realizing that everyone else is backing away. So I wind up dead in that instance as well. Gyro's the only one alive, but if anyone could get a single-handed rampage, it's him. He gets initiated on by... who is that? Slark? Bloodseeker and... Spiritbreaker in hot pursuit. But he manages to run. I'm not sure if he'll escape that. You see that there on the minimap? Earthshaker's just disinterested. He's not going to go help his teammates. Don't help your friends. Bloodseeker gets lifted by Yules. Stunned and nuked by Gyro. He's going to get killed by that bomb. Again. Oh, Gyro. Okay. I'm back up. Looks like the entire team is back up. Prepared to fight again, especially now that Bloodseeker is gone. He's really the one obstacle against our pushing. So we decide to go mid. Or at least Gyro does. Whether we all follow or not, that's another question. We notice the Crystal Maiden down there and the Slark in lane. We roam down here, hoping to get one of them, but I don't believe we get either of them. Yeah, she uses her Glimmer Cape to escape, and he uses whatever that ability is called. The thing that puts him into a smoky thingy. Spiritbreaker is charging Gyrocopter, but if he's wise, he'll cancel that. In the end, we all wind up going bot. I believe this push ends well. Earthshaker buying more smoke. There's a lot of smoke being used this game. Notice a lot of times I just use my minimap to navigate. So it looks like we're going to use the courier here to smoke. Smoke of Deceit. Hides us from the enemy wards and creeps. Hopefully we don't encounter a hero before we want to. Seems we do. I thought I remembered something like that happening. Crystal Maiden gets a haste rune, so she's probably going to get away here. Never mind, Earthshaker with a nice blink stun takes her out.
Radiant's top tower is gone.
Bloodseeker's over there pushing our top lane. Earthshaker goes to stop him from pushing further, and the rest of us decide to take Roche. Now here, I put down my Astral Spirit and stomp, thinking that Slark might be nearby, invisible, preparing to take it. Take the Aegis. Don't want him doing that. So if he was anywhere nearby, he would have been stunned. We all back off. All of our lanes are pushed. So we go back to defend. Eventually, we're going to choose a lane to push and just push up it. It seems like it might be mid since Gyrocopter is here. Yep. Pushing mid. Let's see what comes. What becomes of this push? I'm very close to drum here. Hopefully I don't die before I get enough money to buy the recipe. Might actually rotate bot. Or top. They're both pushed. It would be better if we push out a lane that is already pushed in the enemy's favor. That way, if we die, they'll have more trouble taking our barracks.
Radiant's bottom tower is now a pile of dust.
Not really doing anything here, just standing around waiting. Oh, we're waiting for more smoke. Okay. I think we're overusing smoke here. They're going to realize at some point that by their wards and not being seen. Not to mention Lina's over there blocking creeps. They must be wondering why those creeps stopped.
Radiant's bottom tower has a nasty situation.
In the end, we just roam up top here, trying to see if we can find anyone in the jungle. I think we don't find anyone, and we wind up pushing top. Bloodseeker might have caught sight of us there, or perhaps our smoke just ended. We managed to kill the Bloodseeker fairly easily. I wasn't expecting him to be that easy to kill. That's probably thanks to this. Our bottom lane is really pushed. Someone ought to go back to defend that. I'm not sure if anyone will. We might just pressure mid while we have the advantage. It's like a power play. Now here, I think about going for Heart, maybe? Heart of Tarrasque? I'm trying to debate whether to go for Heart of Tarrasque or Assault Curus. And I believe Soldier, one of my friends on Steam, messages me and tells me to get Assault Curus. I'll probably err in favor of that.
Dire's middle tower is lost.
Here I am, scouting with the Astral Spirit, trying to figure out where the enemy is, maybe harass if I can. I believe there I tried to throw down my ulti on the sleeping enemies, but I don't manage to hit the key somehow. I might have had only the Astral Spirit selected, and thus I couldn't cast. Not sure what happened there, but that was a mistake. Slark goes on Silencer, and I try to stun Slark, but he has BKB, so that doesn't work. Spearbreaker is charging in here against a against our entire team. He gets stopped. But Bloodseeker ults Earthshaker. Not good for us. We managed to take down both Spearbreaker and Slark. I put my ulti down for Slark, thinking he would be the greatest threat to us at that moment, but he got taken down fairly easily. Would have been better if I saved it for the incoming Bloodseeker. But unfortunately I did not, and thus they're being chased down mid. Do they survive? They do. Nice. Got away from a Bloodseeker. That doesn't often happen. Now I have buyback here if necessary, but hopefully I won't need it because I want that Assault Curus. Frickin' gyrocopter way up there on the net worth. Way above there. 3,000 above there. First position. Not to mention we have a tower advantage. Do we have a tower advantage? No, we don't have a tower advantage. Things are even in the way of towers, but our carry is much more fed than theirs. Things are looking good at the moment. We have more kills than they do. All the lanes are pushed. Nice. Starting to work out how much armor I'm going to have after I build this Assault Curus. This is the most armored I've ever been as Elder Titan. Usually I don't build Assault Cure Us. I'll go for Heart instead, but I suppose since they have a lot of good right-click auto-attack damage, it's not a bad idea. Here I stomp, trying to slow them down as much as I can. Lina ults the Bloodseeker. Slark dies here much more quickly than I was expecting him to. Once again, probably the result of this. So now it's only Shadow Fiend, Spirit Breaker, and Crystal Maiden we have to contend with. Our most fed carry, 3rd position and 5th position, should be able to take care of their second, 4th, and 5th positions. I stomp, trying to harass the Crystal Maiden as much as I can. She gets away because of her Glimmer Cape. Or does she? Does he have a gem? He somehow sees them. He ulties. The cooldown kills the Crystal Maiden. Shadow Fiend seems to be okay. I keep trying to harass him as much as I can, though. I try to stomp him here, but it doesn't work. I managed to get the Spirit Breaker, though. I tried to ulti on the Spirit Breaker as well, but once again, I faced the same problem of the, I have the Astral Spirit selected, and thus I can't. Ooh, that was nice. The ulti got the Shadow Fiend, though. I'm glad I saved it for that moment. I missed the stomp on the Spirit Breaker, so I just try and go up here and scout some more, see who I can find. Bloodseeker should be coming out soon. We take their middle barracks, and then we back off since Bloodseeker came back. Bloodseeker ulties Lina. I don't think there's anything I can do to save her, unfortunately. Now the question is, do I get away? I drum, trying to run as fast as I can, but Bloodseeker, being as he is Usain Bolt, I cannot escape. Spirit Breaker comes charging in as well. I try to stomp before he gets to me. Ooh, nice work. Earthshaker coming in behind me, saving from the Spirit Breaker. He ulties on 2? Is that 2? Does some decent damage there. Now we're chasing the Slark. Slark dies. Bloodseeker is low, and so is Crystal Maiden. Bloodseeker gets killed by the Fissure, and Crystal Maiden gets killed by Gyrocopter. Team wipe. We really need to push here. But I realize I have enough money for Assault Kyros. I'm going to get that and then help them push. I'd hate to lose it when they buy back. Only Spirit Breaker has buyback, really. So I guess it's not that important. People are a bit upset on their team about their Spirit Breaker's performance. How did he... I mean, 4-11 against a professional Gyrocopter. Yeah. Spirit Breakers usually do much better than that, but some people have bad games. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Heading up towards bot, going to help them push. Help them survive the impending attack from Shadow Fiend, Spirit Breaker. No longer Crystal Maiden, just Shadow Fiend and Spirit Breaker. Ridiculous attack speed from this Assault Kyros. Helps you get a lot out of the Astral Spirit buff. Slark is back up, Bloodseeker is nearly back up, so we're all... we back up. Somehow I wind up in second position. I'm not going to complain, but that's not really where I belong. Maybe in the late game it is, but I don't know where Elder Titan belongs. He can be built as a support, he can be built as a carry. I don't know. They're trying to push bot back out. What we really need to do is take top barracks. Top barracks. That way we can have the mega creeps that will ensure our victory. Here we go, pushing mid. Looks like this might be a fight. Yep, Gyrocopter gets initiated on by Rupture. I send my Astral Spirit out there, and they are very afraid of it for some reason. I get a bunch of Astral Spirit charges out of that. Look at this. 259 damage from that buff. and my move speed is up to 485. I don't think I get to use it at all, though, which is unfortunate. What was that, 4 heroes and 2 creep waves? I believe they know where we're headed. I threw down my Astral Spirit in that group of people, thinking I might be able to get the stun off before they notice, but they're too quick. They get out of there. Gyrocopter calls down on Crystal Maiden. Slark is still in there. Shadow Fiend is getting crushed by everyone else. Meanwhile, Slark is initiating on Gyrocopter and failing miserably. Now it's 5v2. Good time to push. Here I decide I might go for Ags, just for the, what is that? That's a, attack disable. If they get hit by it, they cannot attack for the next 6 seconds, which is nice. It'll be a good way to counter Shadow Fiend or Bloodseeker if they get hit by it, but I don't think I get around to that, seeing as we're ending the game right here. Throw down my Astral Spirit, run it into their fountain since it can't take damage in there. I stomp Crystal Maiden. Bloodseeker runs out here and ulties me. I ulti. I don't think I hit anyone with it. I keep trying to move around and help my teammates, moving as little as possible while doing so. Bloodseeker tries to run up to me, but it's too late. Their Ancient is down because of our creeps and Earthshaker there. Possibly Gyro, who might have been auto-attacking it. But yeah, the game went fairly well, I'd say. I didn't do well in the early game, but Gyrocopter carried us well enough that I was able to come back in the mid-game and do well in the late game. Lovely.